Hey BookTube, it's Thea and I am here with my November TBR. This video is quite late, but I wanted to get it up for you guys anyway, and I only have 4 books on my TBR for November. I will be making a separate video for Buzzwordathon in the next couple weeks, so keep an eye on my channel for that specific TBR, and I'll just really quickly kind of go through them. Most of them, all of these are pretty well-known books on BookTube, so don't really feel like they need a lot of description. So without further ado, let's go ahead and dive right in. The first book that I'd like to go ahead and try to read this month is The Last Magician by Lisa Maxwell. This is the first book in a duology. This is my November book for my YA book club. If you don't know what this is about, basically it takes place in a modern day New York where magic is all but extinct. There are a few people who do have magic. They live in the shadows, hiding who they are, and any people with the magic that enters Manhattan becomes trapped by the Brink, which is a dark energy barrier that confines them to the island. Crossing it means losing their power and often their life. And it follows Esta, who is a talented thief, and she's been raised to steal magical artifacts from the order that created the Brink. And with her innate ability to manipulate time, Esta can fly from the past, collecting these artifacts before the order even realizes she's there. And all of Esther's training has been for one final job, traveling back to 1902 to steal an ancient book containing the secrets of the order. I'm really excited to read this. I've been wanting to read it for a while. It's been on my TBR for a while. And so this is the first book that I will be picking up in November for my book club. One of the other books I'd like to try to get to this month is The Raven Boys by Maggie Stiefvater. I feel like this is a very well-known book and very well-known and loved series here on BookTube. This has been featured on multiple TBRs. I've tried to read it multiple times and I just never get around to it. So I'm gonna try to finally pick it up this month. I kind of feel like it's just like kind of the perfect like fall atmospheric book as well. And I think it's finally time I pick it up and read it. So I'm hoping to get to this month. I also have plans to pick up Queens of Fenburn by Kendar Blake. This is the 2 novellas in the Three Dark Crown series. I just recently hauled the last book in the series, which I plan on reading very shortly, but I wanted to pick up this novella. I wanted to pick this up and read the 2 novellas. This consists of the 2 novellas, The Young Queen and The Oracle Queen. The Oracle Queen takes place many, many years before this story, and then The Young Queen takes place within the timeline of the Three Dark Crowns. I don't know where it falls within the books, but I'm really excited to hopefully pick this up this month as well. The book I'd like to try to get to this month is Salt to the Sea by Ruta Sepetys. This has been on my TBR ever since it came out. So it's been on my TBR for like 3 years. And my boyfriend and I are gonna start our own little like book club and read books together. And this was the first book that I chose for us. We're picking up a copy from the library as well today so that he can read it. And so I'm really, really excited to get to this. I've been wanting to read it for so long, and I actually met her and it's like a signed personalized copy. So I figured it's about time to read this. And this kind of also feels like it's kind of like a fall winter read. So I'm hoping to get to this as well. If you don't know what it's about, it takes place in 1945, 4 teenagers, 4 secrets, each one born of a different homeland, each one hunted and haunted by tragedy, lies, and war. As thousands of desperate refugees flock to the coast in the midst of a Soviet advance, 4 paths coverage vying for passage aboard the Wilhelm Gustloff, a ship that promises safety and freedom. Yet not all promises can be kept. Inspired by the single greatest tragedy in maritime history, best-selling and award-winning author Ruta Sepetys lifts the veil on a shockingly little-known casualty of World War II, an illuminating and life-affirming tale of heart and hope. So I feel like this might be a little hard-hitting, but I'm really excited to finally dive into this as well. So these are the 4 books that I'd like to try to get to in November. Let me know down in the comments below if you've read any of these, any thoughts, comments, and opinions about them. What are you guys reading in November? I tried to keep it short this month and not be overwhelmed by the amount of books that I'd like to read before the end of the year. So trying to keep it short. This month is a pretty busy month, so I hope you guys are doing well. Thank you guys so much for watching. Happy reading, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!